Hey, we're back for the senior portion of the Old Canal Days Queens Pageant 2022. And again, your host, Gina Hoffman.
Thank you for coming to the 2022 Old Canal Days Pageant. I am Gina Hoffman, this year's MC for our pageant. And working with me this evening is Dan McLaughlin, owner of BACM Productions. This year, we have six young ladies ages 14 to 18 competing for the crown. Preliminary portions of tonight's pageant were held beforehand. Over half of these young ladies' scores have already been awarded. They have spent many hours preparing for this pageant. In addition to selecting this year's 2022 Queen and Report, we will also be awarding the highest GPA, Essay, and Miss Congeniality Awards. Please sit back and enjoy our program tonight. Cheer, laugh, and enjoy as these wonderful young ladies compete for the crown and title. Let's have our wonderful three judges and our tally keeper, can't forget about him, stand up, and let's give them a round of applause. Thank you. You don't have to say that. And now I'd like to welcome to the stage the 2021 Queen, Miss April Franks. April is 18 years old and has been a part of the Old Canal Days pageant since 2014. She has learned and experienced so much in her years she has been on the court. April is hopeful for the future and is so excited for the upcoming courts to come. April loves everything music and art related. If it's creative, then she's probably doing it. She's also following in her footsteps of her father, Cliff, and pursuing photography in her free time. April is sad to have had this been her last year to be able to compete or to be part of the pageant, but she is so grateful for the memory she has made and the beauty of being a public figure and fulfilling her dream of being a queen. Thank you, April. We will have our queen contestants. We'll welcome them to the stage and introduce themselves.
My name is Lana. I'm contestant number one. And one fun fact about me is that I play the bassoon, I play the flute, and I am in three choirs.
Hi, my name is Audrey. I'm contestant number two, and a fun fact about me is that I'm a lifeguard at my campground.
This dress was actually handmade by me and a friend.
I'm contestant number 5, and a fun fact about me is I've been participating in different forms of theater, with musicals or plays, since I was 10 years old.
Hello, judges and everybody. I am Phoenix. I'm contestant number 6. And a fun fact about me is that I got to design, sew, and model my own dress in my school fashion show, and I'm doing it again for my last year of high school as a senior.
Thank you, April, and thank you to our contestants for your introduction. Let's give them a round of applause. Each year, we are very lucky to work with the Academy of Performing Arts at Upstage Dance Studio for their ideas and inspiration. Kelly Comfers works so hard with her dancers and twirlers of all ages to help them embrace the performing passion. Please visit the Academy of Performing Arts at Upstage on Facebook. And now let's please welcome to the stage the junior jazz class performing Cruella De Vil.
To see you is to take a sign and shine.
on to the question and answer portion of our pageant, and each of our contestants here will have to answer. So I'll welcome back to the stage April.
During his deployment?
The most important lesson I learned during my dad's deployment was that you can still be close to the people you love even if you're not really there, and that you can always find a way to talk to someone if you really want to.
Your plans after high school are to attend college for pharmaceutical sciences. Who or what inspired your career choices?
I don't have the greatest health, but I always want to help people, and so one way that I want to do that is by making medicine so that people can get the help they need. I don't want to be a nurse, but I do want to be able to help in one way or another.
I heard that you won an award for Junior Volunteer for Family Readiness Group. Please tell us what that award is and what you had to do to achieve it.
Since my dad is in the Army National Guard, I was able to volunteer to work at what we call the donut table, which was for the soldiers to come in the mornings and get some food when they had to stay over. And so one way that we did that was we got food out for them, and then we collected donations to be able to fund more food and get them better things. I was volunteering there for 7 years before I had to stop, and it was the junior readiness group because you had to be 18 or older to actually volunteer.
Thank you very much. Hi, Audrey. Stephen King is your favorite author. What is your favorite book by him and why?
It's because I love like horror movies and I love like scariest thing, clowns. So I just thought like watching the movie and then reading the book was like a great way to understand it better.
You said your mom is your role model and she has taught you to be independent. What are some of the things she has taught you that you believe are important in today's society?
She taught me how to sew, how to ride a bike, and that's important if I need to go somewhere. Anything. She taught me how to cook and like how to treat people with respect and everything like that. And I think that's important because like everyone needs to be treated with respect no matter what they did to you or what they do.
You said the music inspires you and gives you confidence to do almost anything. What song would you choose as your inspiration to do this pageant?
Just the Way You Are by Bruno Mars, because I feel like that song really shows that no matter what your background is or what you look like or anything like that or what your past is, you can do anything, and I feel like the pageant just sort of makes that more possible. You're going to have a favorite and show people that.
Thank you very much. Contribution is that you assist in the library and school office. How does that make a daily impact in your school?
Well, especially in the offices, the helpers really do help out a lot. And I'm sure the staff really enjoys the help because there's a lot that needs done, and with the help of us, they really get it done faster and have more stress like off their shoulders.
You shared a favorite part of the community is how we all come together to help each other when needed. Can you give us a specific example of when our community has come together when someone was facing a difficult time, and how did you personally help?
Multiple times, especially this time of year, we have had multiple house fires lately. Our community has come together to help provide for those who need food, money, money and all of that, and I've helped by giving away some of my old and some of my older blankets and shoes and stuff like that that was needed for those people.
You said if you were to be crowned this year, you would go to as many festivals as possible and promote our town's history. What history would you share about Canal Fulton to increase tourism to our community?
There is so much history in Canal Fulton to promote that I couldn't just pick one thing. I mean, we have our canal boats, the Overland House, our brick roads, the library, and all these other buildings around town that are beautiful in their own way. So there's really not just one thing I would promote everything.
Social media has helped our society during the COVID pandemic. Has your opinion changed over the last year? Why or why not?
I don't think it's changed, and I think that it's helped because a lot of people deal with self-harm, and if you're on social media, you can see that many people actually go through that, so you're not alone, and it just shows that you're not alone.
You said you are active in the Teen Institute at the high school. What has been your most meaningful project / event that you have participated in with TI?
My favorite event was an actual picnic that we had because it reminded me of a family member that actually passed away from an overdose, and we enjoyed having stuff outside like that.
After high school, you said that you plan to become a dental assistant to help promote and become more confident and smile. What is something you can do today to make someone feel confident?
Something that I can do to make someone confident is probably smile at them or compliment how they look on a daily basis.
Naomi, what has been the most important skill you have gained so far from competing previously in the pageant?
The most important skill that I have gained previously from competing in the pageant last year would be confidence. And although some would argue that confidence is not a skill, in my opinion, it is. Confidence is the act of assurance. It's the belief that you can do it. It is the assurance in yourself. And last year, that was not what I had at all. Last year, Naomi was not the young lady who stands before you today. She was scared of what other people thought, and she did not believe in who she was at all. And from competing in the pageant, I believe that I got a huge confidence boost from that, and it has gone nowhere but upwards since then.
You said your least favorite part of our community is the lacking of learning experience. The hip. What do you feel is missing, and what could you do to help?
What I believe is missing from the lack of history that we can give is the exposure. Half the younger generation in this town doesn't understand where this town truly came from and its roots. And what I would do to help that, I would just put out information, be it on little signs that kids can scan, that they can have on their phone, that pulls up a website, or more staff at the museum and volunteering at the museum, and just telling people about it, putting up flyers, little information packets that you can hand out randomly, that people can just notice and learn about their local town.
You said bird watching is a special interest of yours. What are some of your favorite locations to view birds from, and have you spotted any that were truly memorable?
Actually, funny story, just yesterday I was at camp, which is one of my number one places that I really love to go to watch birds, because when you're at camp, you're always at a different place. So there are different birds in the area, and they're new, wonderful creatures. I saw a kingfisher just the other day, and those are really, really pretty birds, and elegant and proud. And another one of my favorites is sitting on my couch or on my porch, because we have a bird feeder right there on the porch that I can watch, and we actually do have a huge variety of birds, including my favorite, which is the eastern bird.
Thank you very much. our class president. What has been your biggest accomplishment as president and why?
I'd say the biggest accomplishment is being a voice for the kids in my grade, because it's very known for a lot of kids these days of our age to not be confident or allow the fear of talking with authority that much. But I've grown confidence, and I'm glad that I can be that voice for them now at school and don't have a problem with speaking about what's the problems in school and going around the town.
Phoenix, tell us about the time you have overcome defeat and how you have applied it to this pageant process.
I overcame defeat when I was around 14 years old. I had issues with family members and my father, and I no longer speak with him because I've realized from my mother the trueness of how much I am worth and how much family is worth. And from that, it has made me grown with confidence and my own self-worth, and realizing that I can do anything that I want to. And like today, I would have never, a year ago even, be up on the stage talking to you guys because I'd be petrified or think that I wasn't enough to do it.
If chosen Old Canal Days Queen, you said you would love to help local small businesses and create events to help raise money to aid in mental health care. How do you plan to facilitate this vision?
Well, it's all about knowing the right people and not being afraid to speak to other people around you. And mental health is very important to me, and I know society is becoming more aware of it. And if you speak to more people about it and teach them, it's a lot more reasonable for people to want to help, even if it's, you know, something little like coming to talk to someone.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, April, and let's give a round of applause for our contestants. That concludes our question and answer portion of the pageant. And now let's welcome our next performance from upstage, the Junior Jazz Class will be performing to What Else Can I Do?
Symmetrical or perfect, but it's beautiful, and it's mine. What else can I do? Hides behind my smile. What could I?
ladies, let's give them another round of applause for the wonderful performance. And our final number of the night from upstage is the hip hop class to What's My Name.
This is all hands on deck. Calling out to those boys and girls, I'm getting tired of the disrespect. You won't stop to we rule the world. It's upside down, yes. Upstairs about to be set. Things ain't nothing dead. Tell me to charge so they don't forget. What's my name? What's my name?
The dancers and twirlers from the Academy of Recording Arts at Upstage. If you haven't, check them out. They are a wonderful dance studio and Tom Studio. I'd also like to thank our wonderful judges, and I can't forget about our tally keeper for coming tonight to pageant. Let's give them a round of applause. Please remember that tonight's results are also based off of some judging done so besides what you witnessed during the pageant. Wish a huge thank you. We'd like to thank the pageant committee, the Canal of Conference, and the parents of each of our participants. Without their help and commitment, the pageant would not be here today. A special thanks goes to Sarah Wilmont-Banco and Juliet McLaughlin and Rhonda Robinson for their time and efforts to provide a nice event for our community. A round of applause for everyone. Now, I would like to first invite our 2021 Queen, Miss April Franks, to present her farewell speech.
Hi, everybody. Ooh, wow. What a surreal feeling to think that it's already been a year since I was crowned your 2021 Old Canal Day Senior Queen. I stand before you today as living proof that time flies way too fast. 8 years ago, a little girl stood on the stage, shy and scared out of her mind. That once 10-year-old girl who won the title of first junior first attendant stands here on the same stage, 18 years old, with excitement and wonder in her eyes from all that she's experienced in the world since then. Seems like in the blink of an eye that 10-year-old girl was then 12 years old and getting crowned junior queen. And then in another blink of an eye, she was then 17 and getting crowned senior queen. The one thing I've dreamt of as a little girl I achieved, and it's been the one thing that would change my life and perspective forever. I don't know exactly when that shy, scared girl grew and gained confidence, but I know one thing is for sure. The Old Canal Days pageant has been the biggest contribution to who I am today, as well as my mother and father. My mother, who pushed me into this direction and has always been there to buy or make my dresses, do my hair, and encourage my hopes and dreams. Mom, you have always put up with my endless defiance and craziness. Thank you, and sorry. I absolutely adore every dress we have made together and will cherish them for as long as they stay together. We have been through so much, and you have always taught me to never give up, and I thank you for that. Because I don't know where I would be without it. And to my dad, thank you for giving me a step up in this life with this strong-willed and argumentative personality. 100% came from your genes. No, but genuinely, thank you for giving me the passion and magnetism to always fight for what I love and achieve what I think is possible. Thank you for always lending me your camera to do my own photos and make people happy. You have given me the opportunity to do that. Thank you for building our beautiful canal boat float that we've used in all of our parades, even through your busy schedule. You fulfilled Julie's dream of seeing a sparkly canal boat, and that alone is mind-blowing. I know all the girls on our court have deeply appreciated the float instead of being crammed in the back of a burning hot bed of a truck and having the uniqueness of being a replica of a piece of our hometown's history and sharing it with the world. To my 2021 court, I have loved every second of being your queen. Thank you for always reassuring me that I was doing well. To Courtney, Gal, you have always been there to do the Cupid shuffle and cha-cha slide with me and sing frozen duets while waiting for in the float before parades and laughing our crowns off. I know you will go so far if you work towards it, and remember to always fix your sesh because you won't have me to do it for you anymore. To Allison, from the first meeting you to now, I've gotten to see you come out of your shell and grow into a beautiful young woman. You hold yourself so well. Definitely queen material. Thank you for always putting up with me and Courtney's craziness. I hope I was able to inspire and help you get a taste of the wonderful pageant life. Always remember to keep dancing and always help another queen fix her crown and sash, especially Courtney's. I would also like to quickly thank Julie, Sarah, and Rhonda for being amazing role models. To Julie, thank you so much for getting my mom to throw me into this. You were the one who allowed me to be the wonderful queen I had always aspired to be. To Sarah, I never got to level with you like I did this year. I got to know you and have a genuine conversation, and that meant the world to me. You have so much on your shoulders, and the Canal Days Festival would never be as amazing as it is without you. I think even after I walk away from the pageant today, I will always have every speech and pageant talk burned into the back of my brain for as long as I live. To Rhonda, thank you for everything you have done this year and helping me be a great queen. Thank you for having faith in me and always treating me like an equal. And I know once a queen is always a queen, but it's still bittersweet to say goodbye for now. This year has been filled with amazing opportunities, and I've got to talk to some incredibly inspiring people. Even just the people that I just had conversations with at festivals, it just, in the history of this town, have meant the world to me. And all the different queens around Ohio that I've met and gotten to see at every parade and festival and talk about the crazy parade life has been so inspiring. I will miss being able to be the face of Canal Fulton, but I am beyond thankful to have been on this journey and to have been able to share my little historic hometown with everyone I've crossed paths with. Now to end my speech with my favorite quote that has kept me going through all of this and my entire
entire year in my brain.
Tell me, and I forget. Teach me, and I remember. Involve me, and I will learn. Benjamin Franklin. Thank you for listening, and for the last time, I am April Franks, your 2021 Old Canal Day Senior Queen. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss April. Your time, dedication, commitment to this pageant has not gone unnoticed these past 3 years. So thank you for being our 2021 Queen. I'd now like to welcome up to the stage our 2022 Queen contestants. To recognize our best GPA, which we have awarded to two young ladies, one to Phoenix Walker, and also with best GPA is Naomi Amont. Congratulations. Next we move on to our best essay, and I would like to recognize Naomi Amont again. And lastly, I'd like to recognize our Miss Congeniality, and that is Courtney Power. Congratulations, ladies. Let's give them another round of applause. They're wonderful job this evening. It takes a lot of guts to get up here and do what each of these ladies did. So now I'd like to begin with this year's second attendant. Drum roll, please. This year's 2022 second attendant is Miss Courtney Powers. Congratulations, Courtney, our 2022 second attendant. Congratulations. Now we move on to this year's 2022 first attendant. Drum roll, please. This year's first attendant is Miss Phoenix Walker. Congratulations, Phoenix, our 2022 first attendant. To announce our 2022 Old Canal Days Queen. Drum roll, please. This year's 2022 Old Canal Days Queen is Miss Naomi Amoy. Congratulations, Naomi, our 2022 Old Canal Days Queen and her 2022 court. Congratulations, ladies. You did a wonderful job this evening. And thank you all for coming out to the 2022 Old Canal Days Festival. Enjoy your time this evening, stay safe, and enjoy some food. Have a good night. Thank you for coming out.
Thank you all the contestants tonight. Thank you judges, Sarah, Rhonda, and my beautiful wife, Julie. Thanks for coming out tonight. Have a great, safe time here at Canal Days, and we'll see you again next year.